Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast: Session of President Macron, World Presentation of Haute 2019 of Franck, Muller. There will be a new Western Armenian section in Wikipedia. Armenian pottery of Jerusalem on UNESCO World Heritage List. The inhabitants of Idlib demand the military intervention of the Syrian army. Arakelots Monastery. The state television company Western Armenia represents the conclusions made by President Armenak Abrahamian as a result of the statement of President Macron on proclaiming the Armenian Genocide National Day in France. The festive dinner is not a place where we can make a statement about the crime of genocide. Armenian genocide does not exist. Genocide is the largest crime among all the crimes. It is a Turkish genocide committed against Armenians. The genocide against Armenians was not committed only in 1915 or April 24 of the same year, but from 1894-1923 it was carried out by three Turkish governments in the territory of Western Armenia. Working coordination between President Macron and President Erdogan is going very well. From recognizing the so-called Armenian genocide in France to President Macron's announcement in 2001, we still remain in the frames of holiday festives. The only recognition and condemnation by France of the genocide against Armenians in Western Armenia remains the Entente Declaration on May 24 of 1915. The only condemnation and recognition of the Turkish genocide against Armenians in Western Armenia represents the Treaty of Sèvres and Versailles, which followed the trials against the Young Turks. President Macron forgot that on October 14 of 1950, France, together with the Turks, ratified the Convention of the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide, which states that the massacres of Armenians by Turkey are considered genocide and nothing else. As for the rest, I do not care how this announcement will be included in the official calendar of France, since we are still participating in the festive events, mentioned Armenak Abrahamian, the president of the National Council of Western Armenia. Let us recall that on the occupied territories of Western Armenia, in 1894 to 1923, Armenian indigenous people undergone genocide by three Turkish governments. Mastering the art of grand complications, Franck Muller welcomed more than 2,500 guests in his Geneva lands at the heart of the Watchland site. This long-awaited week was an opportunity for the brand to present its two new buildings that can accommodate all their watchmaking craftspeople in one place, as well as their new watchmaking pieces, including the innovative and unique Remember collection. Opened by Franck Muller, Watchland is a unique place in the heart of Gantaud, from which opens a magnificent view to the Lake of Geneva and Mont Blanc. Here on January 14 took place world presentation of Haute Horlogerie in the field of watchmaking. The watchmaking elite was there to discover the new two buildings where the house of Franck Muller has been established for almost 30 years. The Swiss architectural traditions are undeniable proof of the success of Franck Muller's home. Martin Sermakesh, head of the watch brand, said, "I am very happy to be able to welcome so many people in this unique place and share the feelings that inspire us in this work." The participants of the event were able to stroll through the gardens and see the new two buildings. On these occasions, Franck Muller has also unveiled several of his 2019 collections, including Vanguard Crazy Hours, Vanguard Lady Skeleton, Vanguard Racing, Vanguard Yachting, Anchor Skeleton, Scafander, and also the new collections with Avant-Garde inscription Remember. In the multilingual encyclopedia Wikipedia, within 2 weeks will be created a separate domain in Western Armenian. This was stated by Susanna Makarchan, president of the Wikipedia Armenia. Materials in Western Armenian have been written in the Armenian domain of Wikipedia since 2014. Unfortunately, Western Armenian did not have an ISO code and it took a long time to recognize it as a separate language, but as a result of cooperation with the Gulbenkian Foundation, we have got an ISO code, mentioned Makarchan. There is also a decision made by the language committee according to which Western Armenia should be separated from Eastern Armenia in Wikipedia. There are technical issues left. I think these issues will be solved within the next 2 weeks, mentioned the president of Wikipedia Armenia. It is worth mentioning that more than 7,000 articles have been written in Wikipedia in Western Armenian. The Armenian pottery of Jerusalem should be on the UNESCO list of cultural heritage, Elzer Nudel wrote in an article published on the website of the Jerusalem Post. The author represents a six-point list, which according him should be included in the UNESCO list. Since 1922, handmade Armenian pottery has been a familiar fixture in Jerusalem. The floral and faunal designs of Armenian pottery with blue borders have become a trademark on Jerusalem's crafts. According to the source, the Israel national dance, the Jewish spiritual musical instrument and the contemporary poetry written in Hebrew must also be included in the list. It should be noted that on 1st of January, the United States and Israel officially left the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. According to them, the reason for leaving was premeditated attitude towards Israel. The residents of Idlib province, who are entirely dominated by the Front of Al-Nursa, are disappointed with the continuing arrests, executions and theft. They called on the Syrian army to help them in the fight against terrorists. The governor of the Idlib also agrees with the residents and has expressed his concern over the situation as a result of the occupation by terrorists. The population is asking the Syrian army to come and show them military assistance, said Mohammed Fadi Sadun. Since the terrorists of Al-Nursa Front have taken control of the state, they have arrested civilians and plundered their property, homes and agricultural fields. The Syrian government is working to provide healthcare and educational resources to residents of the provinces. It sends medicines to medical centers and books for students, mentioned the governor of Idlib. In fact, neither the Al-Nursa Front nor the terrorist groups near Turkey have fulfilled the requirements of the Russian-Turkish agreement. The reports of the Turkish foreign minister prove that Turkey has sent $1.6 billion to Syria and, of course, to those territories that are under the influence of terrorists, said Fadi Sadun. Turkish officials are trying to help foreign terrorists, especially those who are of Turkish nationality, to penetrate into Syria and terrorists bordering with Turkey, with the aim to change the demographic parts of the region, warned the governor of Idlib. Arakelots Monastery is located in the territory of Mush province, 5 km southeast of Mush city. According to the tradition, monastery was founded in the early 4th century by Gregory the Illuminator. The monastery was, however, most likely built in the 11th century and it was a major center of learning. In the following centuries, it was expanded, destroyed, and renovated. The monastery was abandoned and gradually destroyed as a result of genocide against Armenians. Currently, only the ruins have been preserved. The wooden door of the Arakelots Church is considered as a masterpiece and one of the finest pieces of medieval Armenian art. One of the most prominent Armenian fidei fight is connected with Musho Arakelots Monastery. At the beginning of November of 1901, General Andranik and Gevorg Chaush besieged in a monastery with the aim to attract the attention of foreigners. After a few days of fighting, the Haiduks managed to break the enemy's blockade and leave the monastery under the white clouds at night. One of the most prominent Armenian fidei is connected with Musho Arakelots Monastery. At the beginning of November of 1901, General Andranik and Gevorg Chaush besieged a monastery with the aim to attract the attention of foreigners. After a few days of fighting, the Haiduks managed to break the enemy's blockade and leave the monastery under the white clouds at night. This was all for today. Goodbye.